Our singular aim is to make you matric exam. Welcome back again. This is May, June 2022. This is Creative Physics doing a memo, a video memo for that particular paper. It's been an amazing journey from part one, two, three, four, learning a few things, a few secrets. Remember, don't just watch this video, subscribe to get more. Leave us a comment as well, and also share, you know, invite people to also learn the beauty of maths. Now, we're looking at question number five, which is still on functions. Let's go through. We are looking at question five. Wow, we've really created a long memo here. All right, let's look at question number five. It says, consider g of x, written as a over x plus p. All right, you can see this, that this is a hyperbola. Let's look at all this information that we are given. Very important information that the examiner is throwing at us here. Okay, the first one that we see is that this examiner said the domain, okay, the domain, x is an element of real number, but x should not be equal to negative 2. That means a lot. Already, that is my asymptote. And how do I get my x plus p, the denominator? Look, this is what we normally do to get asymptote. Asymptote simply means where your graph is undefined. So your x plus p should always be equal to what? Zero. That makes sense. X plus p should be equal to zero, which means x equals to negative p. Now, how do I then get my asymptote? We have been told that x should never be equal to negative 2. So in order for me to get my asymptote, look, x equals to negative p there. It means that my asymptote there, x should be equal to, that's the equation of the line. Do you see? My p is positive 2. Let's always sometimes get those signs wrong. Please note, another way you could have done, just you say x equals to negative 2. Then what do you have? X plus 2. And that's your asymptote. That's your equation there for the denominator. Okay, let's see. 6 marks. We want to show that g is given. Okay, let's go. So already we have our p as 2. Very interesting piece of question. Going to create a fresh page here. All right. So already we know our y, which is a over x plus 2 plus q. That's the first thing that we were able to determine. X-intercept at k is 1 and 0. Okay, so x-intercept at k. All right, let's substitute that in. This is my x, and that's my y. My y is 0. 0 equals to, we don't know a, but I know my x as 1 plus 2. Show your substitution all the time. 0 equals to a over 3 plus q. What do? We move that over. Negative q equals to a over 3. What is our a? Negative 3q. Awesome. Now, we're not moving any forward, but let's go check something. There's another thing. Y-intercept, 0 and negative half. Okay, y-intercept, 0 and negative half. In mathematics, anytime we have two unknowns, we've got to solve it simultaneously. I have a and q. So I've got to find another equation. All right, so y equals to a over, remember, x plus 2. I think I can just substitute, okay, my x is 0. 0 plus 2, all right. And my y value, okay, let me go back here. My y value is negative half. The rest is just algebra. Negative 1 over 2, a over 2 plus q. You know what I would do? I would multiply everything by the LCD to get rid of my denominator. Negative 1 a over 2 times 2 would be A, and then 2Q. But A equals to negative 3Q. Oh, so let's do that. Instead of writing A, negative what? 3Q plus 2Q. What is 2 minus 3? Negative 1 equals to negative Q. Oh, so Q equals to 1. Awesome. If my Q equals to 1, and I know that my A is negative 3Q, therefore A is negative 3 multiplied by 1, and A is negative 3. Therefore, my G of X can be written as negative 3 over X plus 2. And what's our Q? Our Q is positive 1. Let's check, is that the equation we have? Negative 3 over X plus 2 plus Q plus 1. Beautiful. 6 marks. Let's mark. All right, the examiner would have given you that 2 there. For substituting 0, you would have gotten another mark. For getting this expression, 1 mark. Now, for substituting X and Y here, you would get your 4th mark. And now, for getting your Q, 1 mark. And for getting your A, there's no mark for G of X because already they told you what the answer should be. So you have your 6 marks there. That is what I think the mark should look like. Write down the range. Lovely. Your range, 5.2 of a hyperbola, is Y being an element of real numbers, but Y should not be equal to your asymptote, which is Q. Y must not be equal to 1, but Y is an element of real numbers. Done. 5.3. Determine the equation of H, the axis of symmetry. Oh, we need our equation. Some of you are going to learn a few things here. All right, this is plus 1. There are 2 axes of symmetry, all right, and it's a straight line. But the examiner says M, which is our gradient, should be equal to 0. We're done. We are done. This is what you write. Just forget about the negative 3. So what do we have? Y equals to X plus 2 plus 1. And Y equals to X plus 3. We're done. This is the positive gradient. Now, let's just for knowledge purpose, if the examiner wanted the negative gradient, what would we do? All right, so I still have my equation. This is what we will do. I'm going to use, we multiply that by negative, and we still cut out that part. So what are we going to have? Y equals to negative X plus 2 in bracket plus 1. We can then simplify. Minus 2 plus 1. What's our answer? Minus X. 1 minus 2 would be negative 1. All right, but the examiner wants the one on the left, which is 3 marks. Oh, beautiful. You would get 1 mark there and then 2 marks here. Determine the equation of H, the axis of symmetry in term of Y equals to MX plus C. You would get 1 mark for your gradient and your intercept. Now, let's look at the last one, 5.4. Write down the coordinate of K prime, the image of K reflected over H. Okay, I'm going to do this in 2 ways, and this would help us understand what the whole thing is all about. Let me try to explain what this is all about. First, reflection is a mirror. I'm going to do it in 2 different ways. Reflection is a mirror. Let's start. If I were to draw, I don't have to draw the whole thing. Let's try something here. Just to understand what reflection is all about. If I were to draw that, and we're talking about K, which is 1 and 0, that's my K. We want to reflect this along the line. We're reflecting along Y equals to X plus 3, because that's what we are told. Reflected, write down the coordinate of K, reflected over H, and our H is X plus 3. Okay, that's a lovely gradient there. If we were to sketch that line quickly, check what we're going to have. Okay, and this would be what? 3. So this is y equals to x plus 3, which is our h of x. We want to reflect this line, that point, all right, over that line. Reflection is a mirror, and you must talk about a perpendicular point to the mirror. What do I mean by a perpendicular point to the mirror? I'm going to first explain what this is all about and try to create something easier for us. But we need to understand. We just don't want to get answers. When you understand, then you have a complete idea of how to approach questions. Look at what I'm going to do. I want to look for the reflection here. So I need to create a 90 degrees. Let me just do this once. I'm going to create, reflection must be at 90. Very, very important. Reflection is always at an angle of what? 90 to the line where we are reflecting. Okay. Now, is it okay to say the gradient here, all right, gradient would be negative 1. Why am I saying so? The gradient here is 1. When two lines are perpendicular, the product of their gradient will be negative 1. Make sense? All right. So if I have a line, I want us to check something. M equals to negative 1, right? Can I get the equation of this line? You're going to see something here. Just I'm going to say a few things. Y equals to mx plus c. And I know k is on that line. Okay, so 0, which is my y value. My gradient is negative. What is my x? 1 plus c. What is c? C is 1. So what's my equation? Negative x plus 1. I'm going somewhere. Just follow through. The equation of this line, y equals to negative x plus 1. Y equals to negative x plus 1. Very lovely. Now, the point of when we talk about a reflection, with this point here is going to be the midpoint of reflection, or the reflected image, the midpoint of the reflected and the original. Bringing in some analytical, because we're talking about a complete reflection. So we're looking for a point here, but this point here is the midpoint. Oh, I'm sure from analytical geometry, we can all calculate the coordinate of that point of intersection. What do? We equate the two functions. This is quite long, but this is the meaning of reflection. Let's get the point of intersection there by equating. So x plus 3 equals to negative x plus 1. If I bring my x there, I'll have 2x, and 1 minus 3 will be negative 2. X equals to what? Negative 1. Makes sense. What about my y value? We just throw it in. Y equals to x plus 3, and y would be what? Negative 1 plus 3, and that would be 2. Oh, so the coordinate of this point is negative 1 and 2, which is the midpoint of my image. So the point of intersection is the midpoint between the image and the original. We know this as 1 and 0, analytical geometry. How do we get this point? We know how to get it, right? We would say, so basically, this is what we have. Let me extract this out. Okay, let's do this. Let me move this over to the left-hand side so that we see the progression. Okay, borders a bit slow. All right, done. Now, oops, that went too far. Just move it a little. Okay, I think we should be good. All right, so, good, we're fine. Now, just to create there. So this is what we have. Let me draw that line out for clarity. That is my K. And that is the image of K. And that is the midpoint. Coordinate of K, 1 and 0. Coordinate here, negative 1 and 2. And we don't know this point, X and Y. From analytical geometry, X plus 1 over 2 equals to negative 1. So X plus 1 equals to negative 2. What is the value of X? Negative 3. All right? And the Y value? Y plus 0 over 2 should be equal to 2. Y is equal to 4. So the image is at negative 3 and 4. I'm going to explain this in a lot of ways. This is way number 1. Let's take note. Way number 1. So that's the negative 3 and 4. I'm going to recreate a second page now, and I am going to count. I'm going to show you how to count. You just need to follow through. Now, if I come here, because I'm reflecting about that point, all right, this is, we got negative 1 here, remember? Now, reflection talks about equidistance. From here to here, how many units? 2 units. It means I need to go 2 units more. And that would be what? Another 2 units, this value would be what? Negative 3, which is that. Now, if I were to count up my Y value, this coordinate is 2. So if it is, let's take this out. Let me take this out. All right. From here to here is 2 units. I've got to go 2 units up again. And that will give me my 4. So we have negative 3 and 4. The image again, negative 3 and 4. Once we get that point of reflection, we can also count. Okay? The third way of doing this is this. Let's explain something very important here. If I have a coordinate, X and Y, and I'm reflecting over Y equals to X, what does that mean to us? Anywhere I see Y, my Y has become my X. And my X has become my Y. This is why it's 2 marks, but we must understand what's going on first. Now, if I were to reflect over Y equals to X plus 3. Check this. What is our Y value? Our Y value is X plus 3. So instead of writing Y, I'd write X plus 3. Because that's my Y. That's the function there. What's going to be my X? Oh, we can solve this. Move the 3 over. All right. So X will be equal to what? Y minus 3. Let's check it now. So I have 1 and 0 moving over Y equals to X plus 3. What's going to be my new X value? Y minus 3. What's my Y? 0. 0 minus 3. And what's my X? 1 plus 3. So what's our answer? The image would be what? Negative 3 and 4. That's your 2 marks there. I hope it makes sense. It's such a beautiful question because reflection is the exact mirror image perpendicular. So we're reflecting over a perpendicular point. This is such a beautiful question. I hope it makes sense. Are we done? Was that the last one? Oh, that was the last one. All right, so that 2 marks would have taken a lot of learners out, but right now we know how to get that answer. Beautiful. All right, I will see you in part 6. This is part 5 of functions. Part 6 would also still be functions, and we'll be looking at parabola, I think, in that question. Remember to like, share, please leave us a comment. We'd love to read from you. Goodbye. This is Crazy Physics signing out, and I'll catch you in part 6.
Is to make your matric exam.